Want to download and play fabric mods in your world? Well, that's what I'll show you in today's video. This video will show you how to download mods using the fabric mod loader. Chapters are provided in the video for you to navigate to the section you want. The first two steps is for those who want to download fabric for the Minecraft launcher. If you're using a mod launcher, which I suggest for playing modded, skip to this moment in the video, as the first two chapters are not required. For those who just want to use the Minecraft launcher, proceed to the first step. For fabric mods, we'll need to download the fabric mod loader and the fabric API. Search for Minecraft fabric on your web browser and click the link that takes you to fabricmc.net. Click the blue download button and choose from the two download options displayed here. You could choose the top installer for Windows, or for other systems, there's a universal jar file. For this video, I'm going to download the jar file. In a new tab, search for Minecraft Fabric API and click either the CurseForge or ModRinth link. On the page, navigate to the Versions or Files tab and download the Minecraft version you're using for Fabric. Since I'll use it for 1.20, I'll download the 1.20 version of the mod. Before we install, make sure to create and run your selected version of Minecraft once and have it closed during the installation. For me, I'll create and run a 1.20 installation now and close both the game and the launcher once it's done. With Fabric downloaded, open the installer. If nothing happens, or if you recently installed Java, right-click the file and select Open with Java. A menu like this should pop up. You have the option to install Fabric either for client, essentially single player, or server-side for multiplayer. For most cases, select client. Select which version of Minecraft you want Fabric to be installed on, and the version of Fabric you want to load. Make sure the Create Profile is checked on, as this will create a profile automatically on the Minecraft launcher. After confirming your directory, press OK. Once Fabric is installed, press OK and run Minecraft. Now, you should see a new installation profile of Fabric for your chosen version of Minecraft here. If not, select the drop-down menu and you should see it here. However, we still need to install the Fabric API. Go into the Installations tab and hover over your Fabric profile and press this folder icon. This will take you straight to your Minecraft directory. Navigate to the Mods folder. If you don't have a Mods folder, make a new folder and call it Mods, all in lowercase. This is where you'll be placing your mods for your modded profile, including the Fabric API. Drag that over into the Mods folder. Now, go and run Minecraft with Fabric once, and close it once you've loaded into the game. To download and install mods, skip to this section of the video now. If you're using a mod launcher, you can install the Fabric mod loader straight into your instance. I'm going to use Prism, but you can use whichever mod launcher you want. Create a new instance by either clicking this button, or right-clicking and select Create Instance. Select which version of Minecraft you want to use. I'm going to select 1.16.5. Now you have the option to select which mod loader you want. Since we're using Fabric, select it here, and the version of Fabric you want downloaded, and click OK. For those who don't have this available on their launcher, like with MultiMC, create your instance first. Now, go to your instance and select Edit Instance. You should now see an option to install Fabric. Select the version of Fabric you want to install, and click OK. We'll also need to install the Fabric API for this to run properly. If you're using a mod launcher like AT Launcher or Prism, you can download and install the Fabric API directly from the launcher into your current instance. To do this, go to the top right and select the Download Mods button. You should find it within the first 5 results here. If you can't find it, make sure ModRinth is selected or search for Fabric API. Select the mod for download and confirm the download here. Now you can run Minecraft and the Fabric instance should be good to go. If your mod launcher doesn't have this feature, you must install it manually into your chosen instance. With Fabric API downloaded, navigate to your chosen Fabric instance. Click View Mods and drag the Fabric API mod straight in. Run your instance and it should be loaded in. If you're not sure which mod you want to download, Modrinth, CurseForge, and Planet Minecraft offer a wide range of mods to choose from. For this video, I'm going to download the Bosses of Mass Destruction mod by Barabob on Modrinth. Make sure to read through the mod page to see if there's any mods that are required for your mod to run properly. With Bosses of Mass Destruction, you will need to download all these mods for it to work. You can view the featured versions of the mod on either the left or right hand side, or if you can't find the version you want, go to the Files or Versions tab and find it through there. Since I'm using 1.20, I'll download the version 1.7 to 1.20 of the mod. Make sure when you download the mod that the mod is for Fabric, otherwise it won't work when you run the game. Now, I'm going to download all the other mods that this one requires. Once your mod is downloaded, we'll need to navigate to the Minecraft directory. For those using the Minecraft launcher, we'll get back to our mods folder in the same fashion as when we installed the Fabric API. Now, go into the mods folder from earlier, drag your chosen mod or mods into the mods folder, and run Minecraft. Do note that some mods can conflict with one another, so if that's the case, you would have to do some troubleshooting to determine which mod is causing the conflict. To see if our mod or mods are installed, load into a world in Creative, and you should find it either in a separate category or amongst the default Creative tabs. If you're using a mod launcher like AT Launcher or Prism, you can download and install mods directly from the launcher into your current instance. We'll go back up to the top right and select the Download Mods button. You can scroll through mods from Modrinth or CurseForge here. For me, I'm going to download the Cinderscapes mod. Select your chosen mod to download, and read through the description of your mod to see if there's any mod dependencies. If so, select those to download as well, and confirm the download. Now you can run Minecraft, and your mod should be here. Do note that some mods can conflict with one another. If that's the case, you will have to troubleshoot to figure out which mod is causing the conflict. If your mod launcher doesn't have this feature, then you must install them manually into the chosen instance. Like how we installed the Fabric API, we'll need to drag our downloaded mod into your selected Fabric Instance Mod tab. Run your instance, and they should be loaded in. That's how to download Fabric and Fabric mods. If those who want to use a different mod loader, or want to get started in finding mods, check out these videos here.